Hi guys, welcome to welding engineering. We see the all are the related topics previously, welding and NDT you can tell, but we are added this painting and coating related. All these topics will include in this channel. So this is the first video of coating and painting related topic. So today the topic is coating painting defect. What is the coating painting defect? This is the normal, this briefly I will give the idea. The contents, definition of coating defects, types of coating defects, causes of coating defects, specific defects. Specific defects you can include surface preparation, application, in service, inherent, flame defects. So definition, what is the definition of type, definition and types of coating defects? What is the definition of the defect? Flaw, that spoils the required appearance and specified performance of a painted surface. Flaw means it can tell the any imperfection. Flaw, that spoils the required, that damage the required appearance, that the that appeared required appearance, it will be damaged, and specified performance of the painted surface. That spoils, that is called cause the defect. Types of defects: blistering, bleeding, poor coverage, loss of gloss, loss of adhesion, wrinkling, spray dust, rust rusting, pinhole, cratering, chalking, runs, orange peel. So this is type of defect is there. You can see in the painting. The causes of coating defects: poor surface preparation, surface contamination, surface preparation. Coating defect, what is the main causes of coating defects? It is the surface contamination. If the surface is not the properly clean, then the painting defects will be appear. The surface profile, it should be also smooth. That's why you need the bath painting application. Poor application, mixing one pack and two pack. If there is a mixing, it is not properly as it's not properly as per the manufacturer recommendation, then it will be the coating defects will come. Use the brush and roller, low DFT per coat. If it is the brush and roller, if low DFT is coming, then it will be coming there. It is also coating defect. Use of spraying low or high DFT. You can use the spray, but if it is low or high DFT, it should be as per the manufacturer recommendation, as per the client requirement, or as per the procedure, what are the requirement, we have to fulfill that requirement. Causes of coating defects, what is the same causes? Poor surface preparation, poor application. This is the incorrect paint system. There is two pack over one pack system. It should be go maybe intermediate primer and the final coat. So you have to go two pack over one pack system. You are giving the primer, maybe you need that 50 micron or 100 micron, is the 50 micron. So you are taking the two pack, you are not competing in one pack, but you are putting the two pack, then it is a problem. Incorrect system for the environment. So environment, you have to check the environment, what is the humidity requirement as per the manufacturing mode. You have to do only this time bending. Anti-corrosive and anti-falling performance need. Poor engineering design, inherent design defects, stitch welding. If it is engineering design with the stitch welding, if it is that is stitch welding and that is a painting defect will come. So engineering design is poor. Poor quality of paints, product batch related problem. If there is a batch related problem, it may be a square or some batch, it is not storage properly, then the poor quality of paint will come. Means it is a product batch related problem, the coating defect will come definitely. Specific defect, surface preparation. Blast profile effect, profile too small gives poor cure for addition. If profile too small gives poor cure for addition, poor key. And profile too large means peaks may protrude through the paint flame as paint wash away from peaks. You see, steel profile, if it is like that, applied coating is coating here and the steel profile here. Paint barely covering high peaks of blast profile. Low film thickness of paint over steel with large blast profile. So this is the paint surface preparation blast profile effects. How it is the effect of the surface profile you can see here. Surface kissing. Due to contamination of the surface of the paint, it is coming the kissing. Kissing one type of defect. This is the due to contamination of the surface where the paint cannot be surface fully. So it is coming kissing. The wet paint appears to retract from some areas, and this is often associated with oil and other contamination. If there is contamination, surface is not properly clean. If there is oil, then this type of defect it will come. The defect is called kissing. Mill scale effect, detachment and galvanic corrosion. The mill scale, when the steel we are taking for production from the steel plant, that is the detachment and the galvanic corrosion may occur. Welding issues. Painting over oil flux residue can cause problem as it is hygroscopic and corrosion will break through the coating at this point. Paint applied over oil spatter will show early breakdown due to shrinkage stage of the coating. Yes. Welding issues when painting over oil flux. If it is over oil flux, if not properly clean, if it is over the oil flux, then causes problem as the corrosion will break through the coating at this point. This point can be corrosion will break through. Breakthrough will come corrosion. Paint applied over oil spatter will show early breakdown due to shrinkage stage in the coating. If the spatter is not removed and it is painted applied over the oil spatter, then it will early also early breakdown of the painting. Special defect is application blooming. Surface effect is amine and amine adult cured epoxies contact with water before full cure. Unreacted curing agent takes some moisture. Not detrimental to flame performance for most of the removed. Must be removed before painting. Blooming. Flushing white surface film soon after application at high humidity due to condensation liquid. Flushing the white surface film soon after application of high humidity. If there is a high humidity after application of the high humidity due to condensation of the flame, surface film white will become. This is a dry spray. 2. Collapses or end from a continuous flame. Paint must still be fluid when it reaches the surface. When you spray the painting until after reached the surface, it should be liquid condition. You see here, spray gun, wet paint merging from sphere, target seal, panel sieve, evaporation of solvent from atomized droplet before they can reach the surface. Lapping. This is lapping. If the brush stroke and the spray part stay visible after drying, if it is brush is not, it is not doing correct painting. If the brushes is not sequentially, then lapping. It can be observed lapping. Most obvious on paint which first solvents on hot steel, especially if aluminum pigmented. Adding slow solvent can end process adding. Pinholing. Circular beads which appear to be free for paint. Circular beads. Pinholing will come the circular beads which appear to be free of paint. If there is no paint is there, if there is a correct painting procedure is not maintained, the pinholing may will come. Bubble breaks at the stage where the coating has already dried too much for it to flow and repair the broken surface. It depends upon if the mixture is not correct, then it will become then pinholing maybe it will come. Sagging and curtaining. Weight of a paint of a surface is too much of the flow properties of the paint support. Due to too high thickness applied, if the thickness is high, then sagging will come. Too much thinner added to the paint, if the added thinner is more, then sagging and curtaining will be observed. Not enough recovery from the expected weight. WFT. Temperature too low or solvent too low. If the temperature is too low, solvent too low, this type of paper will come. Wrinkling, common on alkaloids at high of surface drying of the film occurs while the under portion of the film remains soft for a longer time. This is the wrinkling is defect. Means under portion, upper portion is already dry, but under portion still remains soft. This type of defect is wrinkling. Special defect application, shagging cutting. Okay. Special defect, this is shagging. Coating is a steel. When under the effect of gravity, it is coming in. This is called the shagging. This is called shagging. Downward movement of the paint in a vertical surface during drying process. Even specific defects, application of sagging and runs. You see, it's called sagging and runs. It's looking like same like this. Special defects in surface, mechanical damage. The scratching etc is an unavoidable fact of life, but certain precautions can be taken in terms of handling times and the coating time. If the handling time is there, good handling, then scratching will not come. This is called mechanical damage. Sulfide dissolution on surface. The reaction of HQS with lead pigments and dryers may be uniform and spotted. Not generally a serious problem for long-term performance of the cutting, but can be unsighted. It's not a big issue, but a bit serious problem. The reaction of the HQS, if there is HQS, there is a lead pigment and dryers. This sulfur dissolution on surface will come. Bleeding. Some pigments are solvent global, tar or bituminous coating will bleed through if next coat has strong solvent. Chalking. Common for exposure as UV degradation for the region of the surface. Resin of the surface causes breakdown and the release of the pigment particles. It is a surface effect only, not associated with a true failure. It is a surface effect, means chalking is not associated with a true failure. It is not an actual failure of the defect. However, surface dust must be washed off before applying further coat. Surface dust, it should be after priming complete. You have to dust, you have to dry the primer, then you have to clean the any dust should not be there. After that, you have to coat the further coat. It should be applied. Specific defect, inherent chalking. You see, UV light, long exposure, most of the coating is not affected. But the upper layer of the broke down is by UV light. If the UV light is the upper layer, it is broke down, already broken down. Specific defect in hand, reduced inhibiting effect on weathering. Primers are formulated to protect steel from corroding and top coats are to protect the primer from weathering. So primer, why you are using primer are formulated to protect steel from corroding. Steel, to prevent the corrosion, we are using the primer. And for final coat and top coat we are using because of weathering. If the weathering, if there is some humidity, will become if the more temperature, so how to protect the steel. So that's why we are using the top coat. If primer is exposed, soluble salt will be leached away. And red oxide primer effect might not be obvious, but when they are overcoated, rapid breakdown. If the primer is more than the requirement, then it is a rapid breakdown will come. Coating surface has a different appearance from that when it was originally applied. Yes, it is just one picture surface discoloration, how it is happening surface. This is specific defects, flame defects. This is blistering. Blistering caused by painting over moisture, painting over soluble salt, solvent entrapment, coating permeability to gas, excessive cathodic protection, painting over porous surface. So this is the all for today. So next day we'll go from here. This will be the end one, part two. So this is the last. So I think you go from first to last, every page you can understand what is the defect. And I'll go the next video, I'll go the more details about the picture, how it is looking like, all the defects. Okay, thank you for watching again. So don't forget to subscribe my channel. I'm very interested to upload the more video about the different types of topics. Thank you. And you can I will upload some of the links here, so those people are maybe forget to click some of the videos, so you can I will give the link in the last page. You can see here, so you can click that link and you can see that particular video. Thank you.